know what regulations are, make a chart, or otherwise know your way around. This is one of the customs broker exams from the past. The customs examiner straightforward way say, which part of Title 19 Code of Federal Regulation blank addresses inspection, search, and seizure, right? Well, if you review your chart, if you know where your fingers should go to, if the inspection, search, and seizure portion of the question comes up, you should know that it's 162. And there is no really much learning and understanding, it's just straight up memorization. So, and to put it in your head, it has to be regularly reviewed. So it's better if you not just review it once or twice, or you review it on a regular basis. You make a schedule to go through, whether it's a flashcards, whether it's the charts that you put on the wall, or whether it's charts that you have on the table and you regularly take it, doesn't matter. Put it in your memory, because without this, well, the substance is important. It must be supplemented by memorization as well. So second chart, which I recommend to also start, since this is a kickoff, right? That means that the time is now to start doing that, right? Because memorization part, you can, without even understanding what goes on, you can start laying down the foundation, and this stuff, a foundation of what you are to build your knowledge on, because it provides you the framework, and it teaches you to become a librarian, right? Librarian, like think about you going into the library, right? You come to the library, and let's say you are the physics major, right? You go to the librarian, and you ask him about some physics technical book that you're looking. The librarian doesn't need to have a knowledge about physics. What they need to have a knowledge is the section where all the physics books are allocated. So this is the same concept here. The librarian would take that physics student to that physics corner and would make sure that that physics student have the ability to dwell upon and to dive in into the specific topic within the physics corner. So just as a librarian, you need to know where to get in. Of course, you have to be partly a physics student too, but before you become a physics student, you have to become also a librarian, which this memorization through this framework will get you to. So what do we have here? So we have Code of Federal Regulations. We have harmonized tariff, I'm not going to write it out, schedule of the United States. We have forms and directives. All right, now, this is HTSUS. You need to know how it is structured. You have general notes, which give you the basic introduction to the United to the HTSUS. Know that, for example, General Note 27 is United States Morocco Free Trade Agreement. That's important because customs examiners may ask you on Morocco Free Trade Agreement, and within the HTSUS book, as thick as it is, you will need to be able to point to the General Note 27, because they will not tell you look in General Note 27. They will tell you simply United States Morocco Free Trade Agreement, or worse, they will abbreviated in some form, which you're like, what is this, right? Like this one, DRCAFTA FTA, right? So those who are not familiar with Dominican Republic's Central America Free Trade Agreement, right, will look at this as a bunch of gibberish. So learn to recognize the associate the note with the particular topic within the HTSUS. And thirdly, very important, is learn to recognize how harmonized tariff schedule is structured. Usually the way HTSUS is written, aside from general notes, you have the goal of the HTS-US drafters, of the harmonized tariff schedule drafters, was to assign, to draft it in such a way that everything in the world that you can think of has a number. There are exceptions, but pretty much, like corpses, for example, right? But everything must have a number. This is their mentality, right? So they draft it in such a way that it's specific enough to point you in the right direction, but yet ambiguous enough, such as use other, to encompass everything. And this is the reason why I think many folks find it very difficult for the classification part, because a lot of the classification stuff, they are not really black and white. A lot of this has to deal with the area of gray. And because there are no certainty with this, or the certainty is kind of somewhat hidden, this is a cause of frustration for many. And I think this can be done away with at least starting to become like a librarian and focusing navigation through the chapters. So you should know that chapter number 3 is about fish, right? And by the time you sit at the exam, you should know that chapter number 39 is about plastics. You should wake up in the middle of the night and you should be able that chapter 40 is a rubber. Or chapter 85 and 84 deals with machinery. So those are the you don't need to know what type of machinery, right? Those are the most specific, but machinery in general, right? 84, 85. So toys, right? Lights, chapter 94. Toys, chapter 95. So all those things, pencils, chapter 96, right? So all those things, they must come to you immediately, because time is so precious. You cannot afford lose your time on something that you could have memorized on very easily, because navigation. So memorization is about being librarian. All right. Now, so the way the structure usually works is it starts from the simple stuff. It's broken down by sections, right? And it starts from the simple stuff to more advanced stuff. So you will not find complex goods until you hit, in case, for example, of textiles, you start with yarn, right? The very basic stuff. And as the chapter progresses, you get to the apparel at the very end, because this is more complex stuff. And within the chapter itself, if you take a look at plastics, chapter 39, you have basic polymers, right? In raw form of basic plastic compounds in raw form from the beginning within the chapter, and as the chapter progresses, you're going to have plastic stuff like let me see if I have anything in chapter. Yeah, I have a chapter 39 product, I think. Yeah, right here, made out of plastic. Although the filter part may not qualify, it's chapter 84, I think. But as you make your way into the manufactured good, it will be later in the chapter itself. So you have complexity increasing as you go down the list of the chapters, and within the chapter, as you go down. Go down a chapter, complexity increases toward the higher numbers as to go in. So those are the basic principles. But at this point, what I suggest is memorization is the key. So learn to be a librarian. Finally, you have the materials themselves. have to understand how the publication system also works in order to come with the right materials to the customs broker exam. So, exam materials. So, those, the exam materials, as I mentioned, you have HTS-US, Code of Federal Regulations, forms and directives. Consistently for the past, I think, 10 years, CBP Form 75-1 and instructions has been part of the exam, so it's a must. Directives have been going up and down. This has been a more constant one. There have been CATAIR, Customs and Automated Trade requirements, which were tested almost on every examination, but because Customs is going through the systemic changes, they're going from from the automated broker interface to automated commercial environment system. So pretty much automated commercial environment is an internet driven system, where as the previous system was pretty much software. Internet is defined as a middleware, right? What is commonly defined as. So it provides a common platform, right? So they pretty much upgrading their system to the internet-based system. And because of that, their CATAIR has changed. So last exam, they removed it, I don't think. I don't think they tested on the exam before last. It's still forming. It may go back. So you have to watch the notice of examination, which I talked just at the beginning of the class, to make sure that you guys have that as a part of it. But this is consistent. This is consistent. And CFR, consistent. The question is, what year, right? So the new version of the Code of Federal Regulations get updated every April for Title 19. Various titles get different updates at different times. So let's say FDA Title 21 gets updated at a different time. I think it does get updated at a different time. But Title 19 is every April 1st, new version comes out, pretty much. So next exam would be April, but by the time the it would be third week, fourth week of April, remember? But by the time the April hits, most of the questions are already prepared. So and the government printing office, which is the official place where you look for the CFR, right, which makes CFR available to the public, they take some time. Yes, April 1st is when it comes out, but at the same time, it's not available in a PDF form until May or sometimes even June, right? So what customs examiners usually do for April exam of, let's say, year 2018, they would test you on this edition, April 2017. On October, let's say, 2018, they would test you, likely to test you on April 2018, because by October you already have the stuff. But very often customs examiners also allow several versions, such as what they've done at the previous at the last exam, right? If you take a look at the if you take a look at the previous customs broker license exams, and I have them here in the under the compilations. So the latest one is being October 2017. Look, 2016 as well as 2017, right, can be used. So customs examiners have allowed use of both versions. So October is kind of ambiguous, right? But the April one is no brainer. April of 2018 is likely to be April 2017. The HTS-US though is a little bit different. It's a little bit more tricky because HTS usually gets two huge updates throughout. It gets updated all the time, but it gets two huge updates throughout the year. July 1st and January 1st.